All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Readers. I had a 3 o'clock meeting get canceled, so that means we get to do one more video today. So we are gonna talk about the quantum train, all right? And as Jay has pointed it out for the last couple days, actually, so if you saw his comments, you would have been swimming in the money right now, actually. But the quantum train seems to be getting ready to take off, and I mean, you can very much see it on this. I'll be real honest with you, I moved my profits today from TUP into ARQQ. I regret not picking that up this morning. I saw that thing around 8% when it opened, and dude, I didn't pull the trigger, and I felt so dumb, but I at least wanted to get in. So I am actually riding ARQQ, and that'll be the second one we talk about. QUBT and RGTI. I'll be honest, I haven't really looked at Quant B in a while. I don't even know if this one's the Quantum B one, but I think that's the QUBT. And then RGTI, honestly, I don't think I've ever seen that one. If I have, I barely remember it. So the last two should be relatively fresh, excuse me. But yeah, this one and then ARQQ, I very much know what we're looking at. We're looking at some pretty strong things here. So before we go any further, what are we gonna do today? Same thing we always do, right? We'll take a look at the daily and the weekly to see how these things are setting up short term. We have our five moving averages. There are horizontal support and resistance lines that I do draw manually myself. And then when we are done up here, we'll use the MACD, RSI, and volume as our lower indicators. Hey, really quickly, if you can please subscribe to the channel, share this video on the internet, comment good or bad. Look, anything you can do helps me so much with these YouTube algorithms, especially if you can actually share the video. I'm actually not that good at that, okay? But look, being here and giving me your time is super, super appreciated, all right? So QBTS, again, a lot to like here. First thing I'm gonna do is delete my lines, all right? I think that we're pretty much on the moving averages. I just wanna see what the next two are. Oh yeah, for sure. Okay, beautiful. So I'm gonna delete the lines and then we'll obviously redraw a couple, right? But man, listen, I always say if you can get over the five moving averages, you fly, all right? And yes, this has been overall five, especially in this little window, kind of a small window right here and right here, right? But I don't think we've seen the full power of what can happen when this thing flies from the moving averages, all right? And I kind of saw it, well, why didn't the, I'm glad those didn't actually delete. That works out well for me. But yeah, if this right here breaks, this 279, oh my goodness, it actually might be a wildly fast climb up to 560, right? That's a near 2x right there, right? That's huge to say the least, all right? Let me come to the weekly really, man, there is, okay. Oh, I see it. Okay. The 50 moving average just formed. All right, it actually formed 2 weeks ago. This right here was the 50th week. Again, if I click on this one, you can see the box only has two moving averages. When I click on the next one, we now get that third one, right? So we are so far above the 50 moving average. We're still holding the 8 moving average really well, right? So in some ways, this 251 right here might be something we come down to. That said, man, just looking at this daily chart, it's kind of hard to believe we're gonna drop all the way to here, right? 251. So I think this daily is kind of telling me I'm pretty sure we're out of here, right? So this is the money line, 279. I would set that alert at 281. Dude, I still gotta delete some alerts, man. I've got too many alerts. It, like, market's crazy hot right now, right? So it's actually hard to decide where to put my money and where to look, but man, there's a lot to like here. Look, real quick, we'll talk a little bit about this because in a lot of ways, this is arguably pump and dump, right? The volume on this day was only 8 million. We basically, what is that? 8 times 6, right? That's 42? Oh, dude, I'm doing some bad math right now. Oh, that's embarrassing. I think so, maybe not. Damn. Nonetheless, throw a comment if I don't know what 8 times 6 is. Damn, I'm still doing the math. Okay, I'm wasting too much time on that. But yeah, we pop. 8 times 5 is 40. Okay, so it's, oh my God, way too, this is embarrassing. Nonetheless, we at least 5x volume right here, all right? And the question's gonna be, can we hold it or not? But the cool thing to see is not that long ago, we actually had more volume. The one kind of disappointing thing is that we did drop right? We were up here, then we come down here, but at least we didn't do like a silly drop like this day, basically this day, right? So it did hold a bit. That obviously gave us a little bit of a rise. So maybe, hey, even if this drops a little, hopefully it'll sustain. But more than anything, I'm telling you, I like that we're back over the five moving averages. I like that we did this really healthy bounce on the 50. I like that we never even touched the 200. We have golden cross that. And look, more than anything, the 8 and the 20 are still going up, right? Obviously, this is not as up as it was, but that's still up. You know what I mean? So we're holding the 50. We're back over the 8 and the 20. We're back over all five moving averages. MACD never slipped into the negative. And again, on the weekly, we're actually still over all the moving averages, right? Still a relatively healthy RSI. Could be a good MACD too. And volume's looking like there's a lot to like here. And there's a lot of reason to put a 560 target here, all right? You know, it's interesting because the AI stocks, I remember us looking at quantum stocks really, really early, all right? AI was still flying hard and these weren't doing well. I've actually been saying that, you know, it seems like money moved from the AI stocks to the EV stocks. Maybe it's arguable that money's moved from the AI stocks to the quantum stocks, right? Because again, if I don't know what they're doing, actually, I have not even looked at those SoundHound, Big Bear, Guard Force in a minute since a couple days ago from the video. But yeah, there's a lot to like here, especially just as the sector looks strong. And let's look at the this one right here, ARQQ. So I was actually holding ARQQ for a while. I think I probably was holding it around this and then quickly unloaded when the 100 failed, right? But man, there's a lot to like here. And today broke basically four moving averages on a single candle. Because remember, we were down here yesterday, okay? Monday closes at this 117 that my line is on, right? Under one, under two, under three, under four. What we end up doing today is we gap up over these two, smash these two by a whole lot. Like, this is a very powerful candle. Where are you after hours? You're going up crazy. Again, insignificant up, but more than anything, it's telling me it's holding it, let alone going up, right? And why does going up matter? Because I mean, look, this is basically the line I would draw. We're sitting right there. This is at 151, we're at 147, right? Because look, this line right here could, like, you can, I guess you can say this, but no, for me, it's this one, actually. It is. This was the first break, maybe. See, but this one's lower. Yeah, I'm taking this one. I'm gonna draw this. I am going to draw that. I got to go a little higher. I want the top of that. So we didn't wick it today. We actually did miss it. But you can see after this line, there's so much nothing to lead to 212. And hey, let's be honest. If you're going to break all four of these, you know the next place I'm expecting it to go is right here, right? So, and look, this is the bottom of the gap, and this is pretty insignificant. Like, yeah, there's definitely a little bit of a plateau here, but the plateau is actually more red than green. So we might even completely bypass this and come straight to this. Let me just zoom out. Yeah, there's a whole lot of nothing. And then again, look, we've actually touched the 200. We actually wicked it again here, and we kind of do like another little baby something right here, but it's not like we've never touched this line before, right? So a lot needs to happen for this to break, but yeah, if that breaks, dude, if this purple line breaks, this is the next line. Like, I wouldn't even draw this. Maybe we'll draw, I mean, I think it's worth drawing just because that number is so high up. I don't think, and I'm gonna raise it. I think it's a little closer to that. Sorry, I can kind of tell like those aren't that significant. That's something kind of, one of my problems is I zoom out a lot, and I know some people kind of like say I gotta do something a little better. I do a lot of my things too zoomed out, right? But yeah, those seemed a little insignificant. That's a good little plateau of a few green candles, right? But dude, again, honestly, I think if this breaks, there's more reason to believe we're coming to this line than just this little line right here, right? So a lot to really like on ARQQ. And once again, QBST looked really good. So to me, sector strength is always important. Sector strength, when the volume comes like that, that's a decent MACD. Sorry, that's a decent MACD. That's a decent RSI. Again, I got to talk about the pump and dump a little bit, right? This was 2 million here. Does a little, a 4X, I guess, isn't crazy necessarily, but this is the third biggest volume day, right? No. Fourth. Number one, number two, number three. This is the fourth biggest day in the entire trading of the stock, right? Like that means something. And again, when it happens right next to a good little gap fill opportunity, yeah, that this is why I'm in. Again, I'll be sad if it goes down, but yeah, I'll be real happy if it goes up. That was kind of stupid to say. QUBT. This one is Quant B, quantum computing. Look, again, honestly, in a lot of ways, what we just saw with ARQQ, right? This thing smashes four moving averages and decides it does want to go to the 200. Not the prettiest of candles. It definitely isn't, right? But in some ways, it actually kind of was. It opens and closes relatively close, right? It's not like if you bought at the open and you watched till the end, you didn't lose that much, right? Clearly, that scared a lot of people, but hey, maybe that was even the buy opportunity for some people, right? But man, get over this 200 and we're gone. And my favorite thing as I'm looking here, look, we've touched it a bunch right here, touched it right there, touched it right there, touched it right there, like, touched it right there, actually over right there. Like this 200, it's not this impossible line that we haven't touched for a while, right? That's a real healthy RSI in the 60s. That's a positive MACD. Again, just looking at the stock, this is one of the top days in the stock, right? Like 1, 2, 3, top 4 days, right? So when we see that for, what was that the same for QBST? I don't think QBST. What? Hold on. Can I not read my own handwriting? QBTS? Damn, dyslexic. All right, you guys, I hope you're laughing at that right there. But real, dude, look at this. This is actually the second highest volume day here. Again, ARQQ, we said, was the fifth highest. 4th highest, excuse me. And then we just concluded that QUBT had the fourth highest day in trading as well. So crazy. It's actually crazy that all the volume is spiking just like this on 3 of 3 stocks. Again, a lot to like here. Get over the 200 and man, this thing's not even done yet. So that's a decent spacing, right? If we can get over here, 175, a lot of reason to believe that you're going to come to 260. If you're not in this just yet, you can either ride it from tomorrow to 175 or really go in at 175 and ride from there. What's the 200 at? Oh man, yeah, again, it's art. Like if this thing hits 160, it's going to be hard for me to say don't get in, right? Like get over the 200 and fly. Wait for confirmation though, and that might be a good reason to wait for this 170, right? Maybe what's your 50%, 164, 163, right? But yeah, dude, get over the 200 and fly is essentially the goal that we got right here. So I am liking 3 for 3. And again, I don't know this stock. Rigetti Computing. Oh my God, Jay, why have you thrown me this one and I haven't even looked at this? Look at this. Oh my God, there's so much to like. You know what I'm seeing right off the bat? Today was the highest. So we have looked at 4 stocks and all 4 of the stocks had the highest volume day or the top 5 volume. Like, that's incredible. Damn. Look at what happens here. We break this and we basically start climbing the gap and we filled it. We hit right here. We did. And again, there's a lot of reason to believe that this is going to want to come to 4:30 tomorrow. This is where my next line goes. Damn. And then after that, Jesus. Where's the plateau? I actually think it's there. And then there. Obviously, I'm assuming this was a de-SPAC that went wrong, but damn. Ah, damn. Look, there's a lot to like here. There for sure is. Again, let me go back to what I said for QBTS, not ST. When you break all 5 moving averages, you fly. And look, this thing breaks it here, kind of comes back, finally breaks and goes. That's what I'm hoping. Oh my gosh, I did it again. QBTS. That's what I'm hoping happens here. And I mean, hasn't really crossed it yet, but that's kind of what we're hoping happens here, right? Just do it. Not really. We still have to get to the 200. But yeah, there's so much to like on all of these. There really is. There's not a lot of technical analysis for me to say here. Still a really healthy thing. And the volume is actually what's blowing my mind. So hey, let me know your thoughts and opinions. Otherwise, hey, the quantum train is running, baby.